Aladdin and the Magic Lamp. Long time ago in China, there lived a poor boy whose name was Aladdin. Aladdin lived with his mother. One day, a rich and disgusting looking man came to his home and said to Aladdin's mother, "I am a merchant from Arabia and I want your son to come with me. I will reward him handsomely." Aladdin's mother instantly agreed. Little did she know that the man pretending to be a rich merchant was in reality a magician. Next day, Aladdin, having packed his belongings, left with the merchant. After many hours of traveling, the merchant stopped. That they surprised, he is in a desolate spot. He looked around. There was nothing in sight for miles. The merchant pulled out some color powder from his pocket and threw in the garden. The next instant, the whole place was filled with smoke. As the smoke cleared, Aladdin saw a huge opening in the ground. It was a cave. The merchant turned to Aladdin and said, "I want to go inside the cave. There will be more gold than you have ever seen. Take as much as you want. You will also see an old lamp. Please bring that back to me. Here, take this ring. It will help you." Aladdin was suspicious, but he decided to go. As was told, he lowered himself into the cave, thinking all the while that he would be difficult to climb out without any help. Aladdin entered the cave. And just like the merchant said, there was so many gold, jewelries, diamonds and other valuables. He filled his pockets. When this was done, he looked for the lamp. It was lying in the corner, full of dust and dirty. He picked it and ran to the cave's opening and shouted to the merchant, "I have your lamp. Can you please pull me out?" "Give me that lamp," said the merchant. Aladdin was not sure that he would be pulled out if he gave back the lamp. So he said, "First, please pull me out." Aladdin and the genie, this angered the merchant with a loud cry. He pulled out the same colorful powder and threw it on the cave opening and sealing it with a huge boulder. Aladdin was depressed. He thought that was no rich merchant. He was surely a magician. I wonder why this lamp was so important to him. As he was thinking, he rubbed the lamp. All of a sudden, strange mist filled the room, and from the mist emerged a stranger looking man. He said, "Ha ha ha, my master, I am the genie of this lamp. You have rescued me. What would your wish?" Aladdin was very scared, but he said in quavering voice, "Take me back home." And the next moment, Aladdin was come back in home. He told her about the magician, about the lamp, everything to her mother. Aladdin again summoned the genie. This time, when the genie appeared, he was not scared. He said, "Genie, I want a palace, not an old hut." Again, to Aladdin and his mother's amazement in front of them, was a magnificent palace. As time passed, Aladdin married the Sultan's daughter. He was really loved her, and he married with him. It is to happen that the evil magician got to know Aladdin's good fortune. He came to Aladdin's palace, pretending to exchange old lamp for new. The princess, Aladdin's wife, was, knowing the value of the lamb too, called out the magician to wait. As soon as the magician saw the lamb, he grabbed it from the princess and rubbed it. The genie appeared. "You are my master, and your wish is my command," he said. "That genie, take Aladdin palace to the great desert far away from here." When Aladdin came home, there was no princess and no palace. He was surprised. He guessed it must be the evil magician who came to take revenge on him. All was not lost. Aladdin had a ring that the magician had given to him. Aladdin pulled out that ring and rubbed it. Another genie appeared, said, "Take me to my princess." Soon Aladdin was in Arabian with his princess. He found his lamp lying on the table. Next to the magician. Before the magician react, Aladdin jumped for lamp and got hold of it. As soon he had the lamp, Aladdin rubbed it. The genie appeared again.
"Ha ha ha, my master, is it indeed good to serve you again? What is it that you wish?"
"I want you to send this magician to another world so that he never harms anybody." Aladdin's wish was carried out. The magician was disappeared forever. The genie carried Aladdin, the princess, and the palace back to China. He stayed with Aladdin for the rest of his life. If you like my video, please subscribe and press the bell icon.